And welcome in, everybody. Glad you're with us. Interleague Baseball on MLB The Show. It's the New York Yankees, the St. Louis Cardinals. First now, pitch coming at you right after the break.
2022 St. Louis Cardinals.
So just about set now, getting the nod in this one, Miles Michaelis. How about a scouting report on him?
He's a dominant pitcher, but he can get a little too relaxed second and third time through the order and miss his spots. That's where we see him get touched up. If he maintains the same intensity that he has in the first inning and the second inning, I think we'll see him hand the ball over to his closer.
The pitch. DJ LeMahieu stands in here, leaves that one down.
First pitch, 7 o'clock.
Next pitch is outside. Next one misses, three balls, no strikes. One thing about LeMahieu, he provides a surprising amount of pop from the second base position.
Listen, that's not something to take lightly. Getting that kind of production from the guys up the middle, it's not a strength of most lineups.
And he deals. Swing and a ball popped up. That's a base hit. Off to a good start with a leadoff dive.
Well, that's one of those knocks where you almost expect to get some jabs from your teammates when you get back to the dugout. Totally tied up with that inside pitch. Got to it late and deep in the zone, but he got the bat on plane enough to fight it off the other way.
Aaron Judge at the plate. And Judge spoils that one. LeMahieu gets his lead at first with nobody out. Right-hander kicks, deals. Fly ball down the line. Nootbaar has a beat on it. Puts it away for the out. All right, let's take a look at the lineup. They're facing a guy today who is a strike thrower. Doesn't issue a lot of walks, so they're going to have to work hard to generate base runners.
And when you've got a strike thrower like this guy on the mound, you can't be overly patient as a hitter because the umpire is generally going to give him the benefit of the doubt. So you got to go up there, understand what's in his repertoire, be aggressive in what you can handle. And you get three swings, why not take all three of them? With his control and command, he's going to be in the strike zone.
Anthony Rizzo stands in now and lets that one go for a strike. The 0-1. And that's downstairs and outside. And a pitch. They say it went.
Count is 1-2.
Here comes a pitch. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Two gone now. Here is the young phenom, Gleyber Torres. That one's in there, 0-1. And now the 0-1. Foul ball.
Starting to get some pretty good timing on that breaking ball, but he's going to have to stay ready for a fastball. Don't want to watch one go right by you.
The pitch.
Nope. Ball one.
Recognize that changeup right out of the hand. Just spit on it.
And a 1-2. In the air, out towards right center. And an automatic double as it hops the fence.
Off the bat, I thought they were going to score their first run of the game, and that feels like a tough break. But look at the bright side. Really good contact at the plate, and now they're working with not just one, but two runners in scoring position. So they'd love another base hit right here.
Benintendi up here. First offering, and it just misses. Benintendi, the former first-round pick, Golden Spikes Award winner. Second and third, two down. Next offering is in for a strike. And a pitch. And a count, 1-2. Kicks and fires. On the ground, out to short. Fires to first on the run, and that will end the inning.
Pure athleticism on that one. In the air, legs split a bit, and fires across the diamond. He's going to get a lot of high fives in the dugout.
We go to the bottom of the first. So here's the lefty, Nestor Cortes Jr.
Oh, this guy featuring that straight four-seam fastball, but off of it throws the cutter. And really, he's most effective when he's using that cutter off the four-seam fastball just to miss the barrel of the bat. Not always going to see the swings and misses, but if you can somehow get weaker contact, you have a chance to collect some outs. Now, it's going to look the same until the very last second. So hitters are going to have to make a decision and hope that sometimes they're able to guess right.
Dylan Carlson takes a strike there as he stands at the plate now. The pitch. Good eye right there. And that's through there for a strike.
Well, a good slider from an opposite-handed pitcher has to stay in that tunnel just a little bit longer. Otherwise, recognition can cause you to barrel it up. And right there, the hitter clearly couldn't do anything with it.
Swing and a miss, and he got him. One down. Here's Tyler O'Neill.
The left fielder, Tyler O'Neill.
First pitch, and he has to get out of the way. And it's even up. One down, base is empty. Ripped to short, snagged on a bounce. Kiner Falefa throws the first in time. Two up, two down.
Batting first.
Now we take a check of the St. Louis Cardinals lineup. This is a veteran-led lineup right here. A lot of players with plenty of experience singing.
Yeah, no doubt about that, Boog. These guys have been around the game for a long time, and they may not have the flash that they once did, but they've got the wisdom to be able to understand different situations, be able to think with the opponent and sometimes in front of the opponent. And you always seem to see a team like this. They come to the ballpark, they know how to get down to business, and they understand what the job is at hand.
Paul Goldschmidt takes a ball here as he stands in now.
Way to lay off that fastball up right there. You're looking for something you see well that you can handle, but you also have to keep the discipline so that you're not popping up pitches that are just a little too high.
Next offering down in the dirt.
Not showing great command so far in this at bat. 2-0 count. He's got to execute here or this could get ugly.
The 2-0 is in for a strike.
Nasty 2-0 slider there for a strike. That tells you he's got a lot of confidence in that pitch.
That one in for a strike, 2-2. The 2-2. And a swing and a miss. And that's that. It's on to inning number 2 in St. Louis. No score. Second inning set to go. And now Josh Donaldson.
Yankees, the third baseman, Josh Donaldson.
The wind of the pitch. And there's the strike.
He needs a quick 1-2-3 this time around. Last inning, threw a lot of pitches.
That's a bullet, but it goes foul. And that one almost got him. Kicks and deals.
I got to count 2-2.
Cut on and miss, struck him out, and one out now.
Typically, that high fastball, if it's close to the top of the strike zone, a hitter, if he's prepared for it, can get to it. But that one just had that little jump at the end, which indicates there's a good spin rate on it, and it didn't decrease in velocity as that hitter's internal clock would expect it to, and that's why you see the swing and miss.
It's Aaron Hicks now. First pitch, and he just misses. And the righty deals. Fly ball down the right field line. If it's fair, it's gone. And that is gone. He'll touch them all. And that gives him a lead. It's 1-0.
With this guy's velocity, a changeup is really a break for a hitter. He got a BP fastball, didn't move a whole lot, and he absolutely tattooed it.
Here's Jose Trevino. He's built his reputation as one of the top framers in the sport.
The catcher, number 30,
a foul ball.
Jose Trevino.
And a pitch. And that one fouled off.
That fastball at the bottom of the zone can be very effective. Just got to keep it on the corners.
Righty delivers. Stays alive.
See how the catcher wanted that pitch up and in. Want to try to tie him up. That's the one thing we're seeing. That high fastball, you have to get it up there because of how hitters have changed their swings.
And down on strikes. That's out number 2. Isaiah Kiner-Falefa up to the plate.
The shortstop, Isaiah Kiner-Falefa.
And that's in there for strike 1. The wind of the pitch. Swing and a foul. Pushed off to the right. And that will get out of play. and a pitch. And a swing and a miss. And that is that. But they're off to a good start as they pick up a run on this solo shot. It's now 1-0. Welcome back. Bottom of the second. Now, here is Nolan Arenado.
Meeting off for St. Louis, the third baseman, Nolan Arenado.
The pitch. That misses, and that's ball one. Next offering way off the plate. Darryl Parker assigned to umpiring duty behind home plate.
And Boog, with DP, it's sort of a coin flip on those borderline corner pitches. Doesn't really favor one side of the plate more than the other. Sometimes you'll get a little extra of the plate, and sometimes you won't. It does seem like he evens it out over the course of a game, though.
Next offering misses. Now 3-1.
That's a really good take right there. Slider down and in. Very difficult to get on the same plane and do anything with.
And here it comes. And that's ball four.
Leading up.
Here's Nolan Gorman.
The designated hitter. Nolan Gorman.
First pitch doesn't find the zone. And the 1-0.
Well, we call that keyholing. Even though it's right there and looks pretty good, if he doesn't love it, he's not going to swing that early in the count.
Next offering is in for a strike.
Getting a little frustrated with the strike zone.
Next pitch inside, and the count's even at 2. And now the lefty got him swinging. Now 1 away. And stepping up to the dish is Yadier Molina.
Yadier Molina.
And he swings and misses, and it's nothing at all. The 0-1 is outside, and it's a ball and a strike. And a pitch.
Ball, that's it.
That one missed. Smoked on the ground a second. Dive, and he's got it. One at second. Double play. And that'll do it for the inning.
Making it look easy at the Keystone position. Definitely worth another look. He'll get some high fives when he gets into the dugout.
Back here at the ballpark, here's the second baseman, DJ LeMahieu.
Leading off for the Yankees, the second baseman, DJ LeMahieu.
The wind and the pitch. That one fouled off. The next offering misses. One ball, one strike. Righty to the plate. Gets him to chase after that one.
Big time GM right there. I hate it as a hitter, but standing in center field, you can't help but chuckle a little bit.
Next pitch is in the dirt, and it's 2-2. Right through there, got him. And one gone.
Frustrating end to the at bat for the hitter, and I'm sure that's going to sit on him for a little while. You want to be ready to hit the fastball. Sometimes you can overthink things, and I think that was the case right there.
Here is Aaron Judge. In there, and it's 0-1. Oh, one down. Hit in the air, right field. Nootbaar makes the play, two away.
Up next for the Yankees, the first baseman, Anthony.
And here is Anthony Rizzo. And first offering is fouled off. Left hand batter waits. And 1-2. And the right-hander deals. Two balls, two strikes to count with two outs. Left-hand hitter waits. In the air on the infield. Arenado makes the catch, and that'll do it. Yanks held in check. They lead it 1-0. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And now the rookie second baseman, Brendan Donovan.
The second baseman, Brendan Donovan.
Cortez back to work. Inside corner for a strike, and that is strike one. And he deals. To left center for a base hit. Now he turns and heads for second. Into second base. The tying run is on with a leadoff double.
I'll tell you, man, it's such a good feeling when you smoke a line drive into the gap like that. I mean, sure, home runs are king, but I feel like nothing makes you feel like a true professional hitter more than a bolt the other way.
Now it's the right fielder, Lars Nootbaar.
Batting it, the right fielder, Lars Nootbaar.
And a foul ball. The 0-1. No outs, runner on second. The next pitch misses. And that's ball two. That one in for a strike, 2-2. The pitch. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Next pitch downstairs. 3-2 now.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him.
Thought it was a pretty good pitch. Top of the strike zone. We're seeing more fastballs in that location. Hitters, especially with two strikes, have to be ready to pull the trigger.
Tommy Edman at the plate. Swing and a pop-up. Connor Falefa moving under it. Makes the catch for the out.
Well, that was a pitch you got to crush. Unbelievable that he missed it right there. Now I'm telling you, he is going to be frustrating with himself until his next at bat.
Carlson.
So up next, Dylan Carlson. A switch hitter batting right. And he swings and misses at the initial offering. Man on second, two down. And a foul ball. Runner at second, two down. Next pitch is outside. And a swing and a miss. And that is that. The Cards leave one, and it remains 1-0. Back here at Busch Stadium, John Ciampi with Chris Singleton, and leading set to off lead off the fourth, Gleyber Torres.
Gleyber Torres.
The right-hander back to work. They say it went. And the 0-1. Now 1-1.
He's been pitching well, but going through this middle of the order second time through, we'll see what kind of adjustments are being made.
Next pitch is downstairs. Right-hander kicks, deals. Looked like it was a little bit up.
He hasn't fallen behind in the count like this all day. He's in danger of walking his first batter right here.
Swing and a miss, and it's a full count now. Here comes a pitch. The punch out there. That's the first out in the top of the fourth. Andrew Benintendi steps up.
Andrew.
When you look at Benintendi, think about this. He played in the same conference as both Alex Bregman and Dansby Swanson. Those two guys picked ahead of him in the first round. But it was Benintendi who was the SEC Player of the year they all got drafted.
The organization clearly saw something special in this kid as a prospect, and it's paid off nicely.
0-1 now. And there's a ball. Now, when you think about players in the past or even in today's game, who's a comparison?
He reminds me a little bit of Harold Baines. Both of them lefties, both outfielders, and he's shown similar types of production at the plate.
The 2-1. And that's outside. The 3-1. Slap the other way, foul. Hit hard, base hit. Around first, digging for two. Round second, digging for third. The relay throw, not in time. He's safe.
Showed some really nice patience in that at bat. Worked himself into a good count. Just a cookie down the middle. I mean, those are the ones you dream about. Once in the cage, you're just hoping you get in the ball game. Right down the middle, not a whole lot of velocity, right on top of it.
Now it's Josh Donaldson's turn to hit. And the first offering is not close. Benintendi stands at third with one gone in the inning. Next one misses, and that's ball two.
And you got to wonder, with first base open, one out, is he going to get a pitch to hit?
The 2-0 is in for a strike. Two one now. Line drive takes it in for the out.
Now back the center fielder,
Aaron Hicks at the plate,
and this is a big opportunity for him to pick up his teammate right here.
First pitch, not close. The 1-0. Way high. Two oh. And that one fouled off. Two outs. And he grounds one to the right side. Goldie steps on the bag. And that is the third out of the inning. The Yanks lead one, but they're on top 1-0. Ready to go, bottom four. Here's a speed threat, Tyler O'Neill.
For St. Louis, no left
fielder. Good speed at the top of the order here. You want to get it on, see if you can get a stolen base, maybe get around the bases and pick up a run.
Swing and a miss. That's strike one.
Well, a come and get me fastball right there. He didn't look ready for the velocity. I think it'd be a mistake to throw him anything off speed right here.
Boots it. Yet he beats the throw. He's safe.
Pretty much gifted a leadoff base runner right there. And as an offense, this is where you really want to take advantage. Apply some pressure this inning. Make that error hurt.
No outs. Runner at first. Now up for St. Louis, Paul Goldschmidt. His first at bat was a strikeout. Pitch misses inside. Ball one. And a swing and a miss. Cortez picks over, backstanding. He's in there safely. Runner at first with no outs here. Next pitch is inside, and it's 2-1. Kicks and deals. Chris, with that distraction and a speedy guy at first, he's in a favorable hitter's count.
Well, if nothing else, I mean, this is a great spot for a hitter to be in.
Kicks and fires. Swing and a miss, and a full count now.
With two strikes, may see some movement over there at first base, try to stay out of a double play here.
The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Pretty good spot on the outside, but just couldn't quite clip the zone. That's a stone cold take.
First and second, no outs. Here's Nolan Arenado.
If you don't get ahead in the count, you can forget about having any success against him. Well, Boog, if you're that base runner at second base, you want to be quiet out there. Not bouncing around, not distracting your teammate, the hitter. Make sure that he can clearly focus on that pitcher and that release point.
In there for strike one.
Big at bat right here with an opportunity to do damage. But on the flip side, ground ball, double play, strikeout, that could get the inning back under control on the mound.
On the ground, a second, might be two. There's one. On to Rizzo at first, and they get the double play.
The batter, the designated hitter, Nolan Gorman.
Next is the designated hitter, Nolan Gorman.
You know, this is kind of a tough matchup as a left-handed hitter facing a left-handed pitcher. What you tell yourself is I want to stay square to the plate, try to hit the ball over the shortstop's head.
First pitch just misses. Runner at third, two away. Swing and a high fly ball to left. And Benintendi able to make the grab. We played four. Yankees one and the Cardinals nothing. And welcome back. We go to the top of the fifth, and stepping in lead for the Yankees, Jose Trevino.
Catcher, number 39.
This guy, one of the best Jose defensive catchers going. You talk about framing, the ability to block, catch, and throw. He is at the top of the game. And a pitch. That's a strike. Strike one.
Really good athlete, and many times we talk about, you know, the feet of infielders. This catcher as well. Really quick feet. He's able to recognize the pitch, see the trajectory, and get into a spot where he can block those balls and keep them from going to the backstop.
Check swing, but he went too far. Get a count, 1-2. A wide to kick the pitch. That one is upstairs.
Really impressive with the way he frames, the way that he sets it up, because sometimes those pitches are off the plate, but because he sets up and presents it so well, he steals strikes for his pitcher.
3-2 now. That one the other way, and there's a hit. So a man on base to start the inning.
Anytime you rip a line drive the other way, you feel really good about what you did at the plate. You trusted your hands, you let the ball travel, and you took the barrel straight to it. That's great work right there.
Now it's the shortstop, Isaiah Kiner-Falefa. Went down on strikes his first time through. And the 0-1.
1-1.
Trevino on at first. Nobody out. On the ground a second. Might be two. They put the tag on him, and he'll be safe at first.
Now batter, second baseman, DJ LeMahieu.
So the batting order turns over. Now it's LeMahieu up to hit. Michaelis throws the first. Kiner Falefa dives back in. Next offering is down low. 1-0. Kiner Falefa on the go. Pitch in for a strike. Throw safe. That one out to right. Nootbaar under this one. Makes the grab, and there's two down.
Now batting the right fielder.
It's Aaron Judge now. Siggy, he's got a history of coming through in the big spots. I know I like to talk about, I'm not sure whether clutch actually exists, but you look at the numbers, and this guy always seems to deliver in those spots. Pitch laced into left. That's a base hit. Now a long throw home. It's off the mark and he scores, and they lead by two.
Oh, here we are, third time through the order, and this is where we see the OPS jump up. Manager might have to go to the bullpen a little bit sooner than he anticipated.
So man aboard, Anthony Rizzo steps to the plate. Pitch misses inside. Ball one.
Well, I think it's the ability to assess the situation, understanding what the pitcher has, what he's trying to get people out on, and then being able to use the entire field.
Michaelis throws to first. Judge gets back easily. At the belt and fires. Just missed. The pitch. He swings and fouls one off. And the righty deals. That one lifted to left. Makes the catch, and the inning is over. But they pick up one run on the RBI single. It's now a 2-0 ball game. We head to the bottom of the fifth, and now Yadier Molina.
Leading off for St. Louis.
Well, on paper, it's favorable to have a fairly quick inning here with two of the three hitters he's set to face batting from the left side, same side he throws from.
The lefty to 1-0. Good eye right there. On the corner for a strike, and a count 2-1.
Count is 2-1.
And a pitch. Strike two.
That fastball, even though it's up, that's the velocity you want to go after. Low 90s, a lot better than trying to hit the high 90s.
The pitch. Just missed.
Expect for that guy to come right at you with a fastball, something in the zone, because he does not want to allow the leadoff walk.
The wind of the pitch. Swing and a miss. And he's down on strikes and one away.
Oh, nothing too fancy on the strikeout pitch right there. Just a low 90s fastball. And I'm not sure he was trying to challenge him, but that's pretty much what happened. Very hittable location. but he found a way to just get it by him.
Now it's the second baseman, Brendan Donovan. Swing and a miss. Oh, and he lost the handle on that one. And the pitch. Bounce to the left side. Throw on to Rizzo. Home half of the fifth inning, moving along. Two quick outs.
The right fielder.
Here's another look with Statcast singing. The throw needed to be strong to beat the runner, and it was.
Yeah, that play was close, and I think we need to credit that 88-mile-per-hour throw as the difference maker right there. That's just impressive.
Lars Nootbaar next up for the Cardinals. Struck out swinging his first time. That one's in there, 0-1. The pitch. Way high with that one. And now it's even 1-1. And a pitch. Fought off foul.
Now this offense has just been locked down. Almost five full innings of shutout baseball.
Two down, nobody on. And that's down and away. The 2-2. That's inside. Swings through that, and it's a strikeout. And that ends the inning. Nothing doing there for St. Louis. They're still down. It's 2-0. Welcome back. Gleyber Torres up to the plate.
Leading off for the Yankees, the designated hitter, Gleyber Torres.
Michaelis back to work. There's a strike.
Well, you can't really adjust your game plan for that last pitch. Guy hasn't thrown it very much. You got to focus on the stuff that he's throwing up there most of the time.
The 0-1 is outside, and it's a ball and a strike. Line drive caught.
Now batting, the left fielder, Andrew Benintendi.
Andrew Benintendi up to the plate. And that one is lifted in the air. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. Two down.
Now batting, third baseman, Josh Donaldson.
Here's Josh Donaldson. Swings through that one. 0-1.
Really consistent release point. He's been able to pitch up and down and have excellent command at both locations.
Yoan on the ground to third, over to first, and they take care of Donaldson for the out. That ends the frame. 9-1-2 scheduled to hit in the home half of the sixth. It's the Yankees 2 and the Cardinals nothing. Back here in St. Louis, and stepping in is the speedy Tommy Edman. He's someone that you might not describe as having elite level speed, but he can absolutely move, and it is a factor in his game. First offering misses the mark.
Well, this guy's definitely a plus runner, but what I love about him is that he goes all out every single time, never takes a break. Guys like that, even though they don't have the elite speed, the fact that they're consistent with it, they make moves on the base paths.
And Benintendi able to make the grab. And they get Edmund for the out. And there's one down.
The center fielder, number three, Dylan.
So the lineup flips over. Dylan Carlson next up for the Cardinals. First pitch, and that's in for a strike.
It really looks like these hitters have been in between with their timing today. Good fastball, excellent slider, but they've not been able to commit to one velocity and stay there.
And now the lefty. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. In the air, right field, and that is a foul ball. A wind of the pitch. Slice down the right side.
You could see he was trying to stay back long enough to handle the off-speed pitch, but just a little tardy on the fastball.
The other way, that's a hit. So a man aboard now with one away.
Now back.
Only two hits allowed so far tonight, Boone, so I don't think that one will disrupt his momentum all that much. You know, he's really been on top of his game, commanding his pitches all night long.
Man at first with one gone, and now here's the speed threat, outfielder Tyler O'Neill.
Now this guy's definitely looking for a big swing of the bat right here. Try to close that gap. But, you know, at the very least, if you could find a way to manufacture that run from first, it feels like it's really important to getting back into this ballgame.
Runner on the goal. That's in for a strike. And that's a stolen base, not even close.
When your catcher's not a great thrower, you have to do a better job at controlling the running game. And that's throwing over, that's stepping off, doing whatever you can to try to keep that base stealer's rhythm off. Well, they weren't able to do it right there. They're going to have to make some type of adjustment, or guys are going to be running all game.
Nope. Next pitch misses, and it's a ball and a strike. Runner leads away at second. They say he went. Carlson leads off second with one gone in the inning. That one to first. Oh, great stop. Takes it himself, and he got him. Nicely done at first for the out.
Now back.
First of all, that's a great diving stop to keep the ball on the infield. Then he's able to get up and get an out. He also keeps that runner from advancing any further. If that ball gets through, the complexion of this inning could be drastically different.
Here's Paul Goldschmidt. First offering, and it just misses. Next offering is in for a strike. Two outs with a runner at third. Liner, and they get Goldschmidt for the out, and that's the inning. So one left for the Cardinals. They trail things here 2-0. Hacking Naughton into the game, and his job is to collect quick outs and keep his team within striking distance.
Naughton.
All set for the start of the inning. Here's Aaron Hicks.
Leading off for the Yankees, the center fielder.
This has always been the better side for Aaron Hicks. And he deals. And there's a foul ball. Here's your one. Lifted in the air out to left. Pulls it in on the run. And there's one down.
Just pulled off of it a little bit right there. That front shoulder coming open instead of staying closed. If he does that, he's going to be able to go up the middle the other way with some authority instead of a fly out to left.
Jose Trevino stepping in now for the Yankees. One for two. And the first pitch misses for ball one. The big lefty turns, kicks, deals. Liner caught it second.
Now batting, shortstop, Isaiah Kiner-Falefa.
Two outs, bases empty. And here is Isaiah Kiner-Falefa. In the air, center field. And that'll do it. Down in order, go the Yankees. But they hold the 2-0 lead. Bottom of the inning. Here's Nolan Arenado.
Well, these fans definitely want to get involved in the game. All it's going to take is to get the leadoff man or even a base runner on.
Here comes a pitch. Swings through that one.
It normally does damage on that pitch in that location. Just a swing and a miss there. I don't think you want to throw it again, though.
You'll one.
No, that's down.
Movement in the Yankees' pen. Jonathan Loaisiga appears to be getting loose. Peralta warming up as well. Here's a 1-1. That's down and in.
Now you get to this part of the order. Yeah, there's some pop there, but more likely there's some base hits. So very important to be patient. Let the pitcher walk you, if he will.
Next offering clips the zone count, even at two. Turned on, but foul wide of third. And here it comes. And that one popped to short. And there's one down.
Now batting, the designated hitter, Nolan Gorman.
Next to hit, Nolan Gorman. In there, and it's 0-1. Yoan. That one missing inside. Left-hand hitter waits. Line drive. And it hops over the wall for an automatic double.
Well, there's something really nice about getting yourself an automatic double like that. You get to stroll into second base without having to worry about a throw or getting your uniform dirty. And now you're just looking for the next guy to kind of do the same thing. Maybe put one in the gap so you can jog home as well.
One down. Now Molina at the plate. Pitch misses inside. And that is ball one. Tying run at the plate. And a good eye there. Kicks and deals. now 3-0. Appears they're working around him with the base open, Singy.
Well, you know, these 2-0 counts, Boo, they're just not what they used to be, and we sound like old guys when I say that, but ultimately, this is a strategic game, and you expect to see this type of approach by the pitcher in this situation.
Gorman, the runner at second with one away. And ball four, two aboard.
He's making things difficult for himself right now out there on the mound, but you know his confidence should still be high enough to get out of this, but he's going to have to buckle down right here.
Donovan in the box for the third time today as he takes that one off the plate. And a pitch. There's the strike. The lefty closing in on 100 pitches. Ground ball left side could be two. Angelo Mayhew. Double play. They can't seem to break through. Inning over.
They made it look easy, but it started with a nice feed to the second baseman from the shortstop. Perfect turn, and they're out of this jam.
Back here at the ballpark, now at the plate, DJ LeMahieu.
Leading off for the Yankees, the second baseman, DJ LeMahieu.
The pitch. Swing and a miss. Strike one. The pitch. Turned on, but that's foul down the third baseline. Kicks and fires. Bounce to the right side. Tosses to first, and that's one away as the leadoff man is out in the eighth.
Now batting, right fielder, Aaron Judge.
And now big number 99, Aaron Judge. And that's in there for strike one. Here's a swing and a drive left field, and he knew it. Aaron Judge leads the yard, and they tack on to their lead. It's 3-0.
What I love about this swing is he stayed tall, allowed his hands to go directly to the baseball, letting that bat head get down through the ball to create backspin and hit it out of the ballpark. Really nice job.
Anthony Rizzo stepping in now for the Yankees.
Now batting, the first baseman, Anthony.
First pitch doesn't find the zone.
Part of the order coming through now, and with one home run already in this inning, they're definitely looking to do some more damage.
Next offering upstairs.
Well, they gave up the home run earlier in this inning, not pitching as aggressively here.
The next offering misses, and it's 3-0. Hawaii to kick the pitch. Late on that fastball.
One thing on his mind right there with that swing. He's trying to go deep.
And a pitch. Fouls one away, and now 3-2. Left-hand batter waits. And there's ball four.
Oh, looking for a swing and miss right there, or for the ump to help him out and make a call with that last pitch, now but neither happened. Close pitch, but a good Glaber take to earn that walk.
Glaber Torres up to hit. In there for strike one.
Good approach right there. You want to get something just a little higher that you can elevate. Stay out of that double play.
And it's 1-1. And another ball.
Last couple of pitches, breaking balls away. I think he's going to have to come firm inside to be able to open up that location if he wants to go back there later in this count.
The pitch. That misses the zone, and that's ball three. The 3-1 in for a strike, full count. And it's ball four. He missed down low.
Now batting, the left fielder.
So one out with two aboard. Now it's Andrew Benintendi to hit. And he swings and misses, and it's nothing and one.
Just a bit tardy there. Not sure if he had a hard time picking it up out of the hand or if he was sitting off speed.
Runners at first and second with one gone. Two on, one out. Fly ball to right. Nootbaar settles underneath it, and it's caught for the out.
Now batting, third baseman.
So first and second with two outs. Now the third baseman, Josh Donaldson. First offering misses the mark.
Well, this is a critical spot for both the pitcher and the hitter. You can learn a lot about a guy by how he handles these pressure situations.
Foul ball.
His eyes got big. He saw that changeup way out in front. Better to pull it than to get jammed on something off speed like that.
Two outs, and it's fouled away. One and two now. Swing and a miss, and that is that. Solo homer extends the Yankees' lead. It's now 3-0. Back here at Busch Stadium, leading off, Lars Nootbaar.
Leading off for St. Louis, the right fielder, Lars Nootbaar.
The pitch. And first offering is fouled off. The wind of the pitch. Swing and a ball lifted left field. Nobody can get there, and it's a foul ball. And now the lefty. And that one missing low. Activity in the bullpen for the Yankees. Clay Holmes, the closer, getting cranked up for a possible save opportunity. And a pitch. Swing and a miss, and he is down on strikes for the third straight at bat.
Well, they've had a great plan of attack for him tonight. I mean, finding all the holes in his swing and his approach, just frustrating for him up there. You strike out a guy three times in a game, I think that guy's got to go back and really study some video with his hitting coach, figure out how they're beating him, make this adjustment really quick, because word will get around the league in a hurry.
At the plate, Tommy Edman. Slice to right. And makes the grab. And a couple of quick outs.
The center fielder, number three, Dylan.
This is Dylan Carlson. And he's already singled in this game. Lifted in the air, right center field. Hicks moving to his left. Flashes the leather on the running catch. And that's the third out. 1-2-3 go to Cardinals. They trail it here 3-0. Welcome back. Now here's Aaron Hicks.
Leading off for the Yankees, the center fielder, Aaron Hicks.
And he deals. And ball one. And the 1-0. Not the best swing that time from the first round pick. That's a strike, and it's 1-2. The wind of the pitch. Stays alive. The 1-2. And a foul ball. He stays alive. In the air. Out towards left center. Brings it in, and there's one away.
The catcher, number 39, Jose Trevino.
Now the catcher up to hit, Jose Trevino. He is at the top of the game in terms of defense at the catching spot. Now fly ball to right center. Newtball makes the play. And there's two away.
Now back.
Isaiah Kiner-Falefa stepping in now for the Yankees. That one's in there, 0-1. That misses, and that's ball one. Left field. O'Neill makes the catch, and that'll do it. 2-3-4 set to hit in the bottom of the ninth. Yankees 3 and the Cardinals nothing. So bottom of the ninth, and the batter now, Tyler O'Neill.
Meeting up for St. Louis, the left fielder, Tyler.
He's been so sharp today, even over 100 pitches thrown. His skipper is leaving him in there to finish the job.
And the first pitch misses for ball one. Next offering is in for a strike.
In this situation, you expect the batters to be a little more patient, possibly take until they get a strike. With that, you don't want to miss your opportunity to get ahead early in the count. He didn't right there.
Next offering misses. 2-1.
You got 2 balls, 1 strike.
Down the line towards the corner. Judge makes the grab. One away.
Now batting, first baseman, Paul Goldschmidt.
Now it's Goldschmidt up to the plate. He's a guy who does it all. With the lack of contact in today's game, this guy hits for contact, so he delivers average, but there's on-base and slugging too. Pitch misses inside, and that's ball one.
Early in the count, you have to be real careful because of that power, but then if this hitter gets a strike or two on him, he's still very comfortable. And because he has the ability to get the barrel to the baseball, he's a threat deep into the count as well.
And the pitch. Oh, now this one's high and deep. Way back there. On its way. Gone.
When you're lacking velocity, it's so critical that you move the ball around, change speeds, even try to trick the hitter at times. But when you give up a home run right there, manager doesn't have a lot of patience because the velocity's not there to overcome and get the swing and miss.
And here comes the Yankees manager to the mound. Pitching change coming. Nestor Cortes Jr. is done, and he was a tough nut to crack. Pretty stingy from start to finish. Back with the new arm after a quick break. So the closer summoned from the bullpen, Clay Holmes. And he'll work on holding this lead.
Number 35, Clay Holmes.
Now up the Cardinals' number 4 hitter, Nolan Arenado.
Now batting, third baseman, Nolan.
First pitch, and that's in for a strike. The 0-1.
The guy at the plate could recognize slider out of the hand. Didn't stay in the tunnel very long in terms of depth and perception. He knew right away it was an off-speed pitch.
So now 1-2. Right-hander kicks, deals. Ground ball left side. And that's just foul. And a pop-up, right side, foul territory. And just foul. The 1-2. And a ball evens the count.
This guy's a fun guy to watch taking it bad. He just battles up there. He doesn't take a pitch off at all. Makes it so difficult on the pitchers out there. You can tell they get frustrated with how long it takes to put him away.
Righty to the plate. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout. Two out.
And he'll be beating himself up on the way back to the dugout. Got a pitch to hit and just now couldn't get to it. I think that slider really caught way more of the plate than it was supposed to.
Gourmet.
Nolan Gorman next up for the Cardinals. First pitch is in the dirt. Two-run game, a two away here in the bottom of the ninth. Next one misses. Now 2-0.
Nasty backdoor slider. There's really nothing you can do with that if you swing at it. So that's a good take by him.
Next pitch is outside.
Pressure mountain right here with the tying run in the on deck circle. He's got to find the strike zone.
Here's a high fly ball out to center.
Tanner Falefa
under it. He's got it. Ball game. The Yankees claim the win here behind some great pitching and defense.
Great pitcher's duel in this one. You get to a certain point where each pitcher is trying to outdo the other, go a little bit deeper into the ball game. And for these guys, it really came down to a few key at bats. This was a fun one to watch.
And your final 3-1 for Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show. I'm John Shambi. We'll see you soon.
Our final line score tonight, first for the victorious Yankees, 3 runs on 7 hits, 1 error. They left 6.